Badger Show. I am, of course, your host, the Badger, and welcome to Spooky Saturdays. On today's Spooky Saturday, Badgeteers and Badgerettes, we're going to be reviewing the fan film Ripper, which is about Batman versus Jack the Ripper. This is going to be a really good one, and if you haven't seen it, guys, you really need to. The film is written by and directed by James Campbell, and he really gets it on point. It's a really great fan fiction film. Now, the influences from this film remind me of such things like the DC comic book Batman, Gotham by Gaslight. And of course, the classic Johnny Depp film, From Hell, which also had a comic book adaptation. So these are really good influences to the film. Now, they get it on point, you know, like you get the brooding aspect of Batman in the Victorian era, lots of leather, the weapons are very downgraded. You're not going to see any modern technology with Batman. He's going to have to rely on knives, his detective skills, and, you know, quick wits to beat the Ripper. Now, there's some other influences. Obviously, you've got From Hell, which the detective from that and the detective from Ripper have lots of coincidences towards each other, lots of elements of each other, and they both have to go down and chase the dragon and try and figure out via lucid dreams who the Ripper could be. And there's lots of different things on there. They're very similar characters. So that's why I compare the character of the detective from Hell and the character from Ripper. Now, the music seems very electronic to me, which does fit with the horror atmosphere of the sort of Victorian era in a way. And they're sort of going with a weird steampunk vibe with the Batman look, so it does work in some ways. It reminds me of a horror film called Zombie Flesh Eaters, and that sort of has a lot of electronic influences on it, and so does a lot of Italian horror cinema. So these are quite interesting comparisons, and it's interesting that they went with like an electronic score to cause tension and scares, which you don't really see that much now in modern cinema. So it's quite a throwback to hear that sort of music. Really good, actually. The special effects are really good. They're not very sort of in your face. Now, I like the fact that they're not in your face, actually, because I feel that if you have too much blood and gore in it, it detracts from the storyline. So well done, guys, for that. Obviously, they were on a limited budget because this is a YouTube fan film made by fans for the fans. So in a way, it does work. The fact that there's limited gore does actually fit it. But you do see some gore in flashbacks and dream sequences, but there's some really good sort of the way Jack the Ripper does it. And it's all about the descriptions, like, oh, there's more out of her than in. And it's all about descriptive, so similar to Texas Chainsaw Massacre, the very first one, where you don't actually see that much. It's all in the head. It's the same with Ripper, where they talk a lot about the gore and the blood and what happens to the prostitutes, but actually you don't see that much, which is quite interesting. The director leaves it all in your head, which is very interesting, and I like that sort of style of cinema. The darkness and brooding atmosphere and the music really help judge the extra tension. One nitpick was the fact that there was a few scenes in there where I thought it was too dark, so you couldn't really see what was going on. Obviously, I know they want to make Batman dark and brooding, and they want some of the action scenes to be sort of cloaked in disguise and things like that, but perhaps a little too dark, guys, I thought. Maybe a tiny bit of light on some of the scenes would have been really good. The closing 5 to 6 minutes of the film is really good. The spotlight on Jack the Ripper is really well done in the scene of Batman and, of course, the Ripper in the same room as each other. That was a very interesting twist there. I'm not going to spoil it, but there's lots of comparisons between modern films there. So, you know, The Dark Knight and, of course, lots of different things like that. Actually, it reminded me a lot of the 1980s Batman film starring Michael Keaton, where there's situations with the Ripper and, of course, Batman that remind me of things like that. The really good twist is there. I really recommend you see this Batman Arkham style film. And it does remind me of like sort of like a H.P. Lovecraft style vibe to there. They've really taken some really good influences. There's lots of good stuff going on in this film. I must admit, even the costumes were really good. The Victorian era is really well done, and I really enjoyed the makeup. So I've really enjoyed this fan fiction film, and I've been looking forward to it for a long time, and I think they've done it justice. There was a lot of hiccups during production, I hear, but I'm really glad it's here with us now, and I really hope you guys have all the sort of success that you've been hoping for, because you guys deserve it. Now, I would definitely say that this film has earned a badger-tastic 5 out of 5, and it's a really good gore-festing horror. So if you like Batman, if you're interested in Jack the Ripper mythos, then this is definitely one for you. Okay guys, I hope you enjoyed today's Spooky Saturday, and please comment below if you enjoyed this review. Let me know if I've missed anything out, because I'd love to know what you thought of my reviewing skills. I'm still practicing, so I'd love to know what you think. And of course, I'll be live streaming tonight, 11 o'clock, on my channel, doing Life is Strange. So please check that out. If it's not directly at 11, it'll either be a bit before or after. But I'll be posting updates on there soon on my Facebook page. So please check it out very soon, and I'll see you tonight for Life is Strange on the PS4 live stream. Bye.